Hello everyone, and welcome to another tutorial on vector in motion. This is the third video on analysis of frames, and in today's video we are going to analyze frames that support pulleys. We are going to solve two problems, and here in the first problem that you see on your screen, we have to find support reactions at points B and E of the frame. As you can see, these are pin supports. So when we draw a video of the entire frame, we shall show two reaction forces at B and two at E. So in all, we shall have four unknowns, and we shall have only three equilibrium equations to solve them. It is obvious we will not be able to solve all four of them from the ABD of the entire frame, but let's go ahead and solve as many as we can, and later we'll dismember the entire frame and pick up one of the members and solve the remaining unknowns. So the ABD of the entire frame will look like this. So there are in all four unknowns, and we have three equilibrium equations. So we first take moment of all the forces about point B, so that we eliminate these two forces from our equation. Even Ey would be eliminated from our equation, since it passes through point B, and we'll have a single unknown Ex in that equation. So Ex times 150 minus 300 times this distance, which is 180 plus 120 plus the radius of the pulley, which is 50 mm. So 300 times 350 would be the moment of this force, and we can write this equation from which we shall get Ex as 700 newtons. Next, we write the force summation equation in x direction, so we'll have Bx plus Ex equal to 0, and since we know Ex, we can find out Bx, which turns out to be minus 700 newtons. Next, we write the force balance equation in the vertical axis, the y-axis, and we have By plus Ey minus 300 equal to 0. So we have two unknowns in this equation, and we'll not be able to solve this. So from this exercise, we have been able to get value of only two force components, Ex and Bx. Two are remaining, By and Ey, which we shall be able to get by dismembering the frame, and we can choose either of the two members. For this solution, we'll choose this member, draw its ABD, and solve for the remaining two unknowns, By and Ey. The ABD of this member, ECA, will look like this. These are the two reaction components at point E. These are the two reaction components at C. These forces are due to the interaction of the other member BD acting on member ECA. There would be a tension force, and that will act at point A in rightward direction. So the ABD of this member is complete, and if we take moment of all the forces about point C, these two forces will get eliminated, and we shall have only one unknown Ey in our equation. So we write this moment equation about point C, and Ey turns out to be 500 newtons. And once we know Ey, we can plug in its value in this equation and get the value of By, which works out to minus 200 newtons. So this is fairly a simple exercise. So the reaction force components at point B are Bx and By, which are 700 newtons and 200 newtons. These are the directions of the two forces. And the reaction components at point E are 700 newtons in positive x direction, and Ey is 500 newtons in positive y direction. So this is our answer. While dismembering the entire frame, we could have taken the other member also for our analysis, and that would give the same result. Instead of this member, ECA, if we decide to go in for FBD of member BD, it will look like this. These are the two tension forces of the cable. Once we take moment of all the forces about point C, these two forces would get eliminated. BX would also get eliminated because it passes through point C. So in our equation, we'll have only one unknown, that is BY. And this would be our equation, the moment equation about point C. Therefore, we get the value of BY as minus 200 Newton. So in lieu of this member, we could have taken FBD of this member and come to the same result. Once we get the value of BY, we again use this equation and get the value of EY. So in short, while dismembering the entire frame, we could take any of the members and get the same result. We shall now move over to another problem, which is slightly more complicated. Here in this problem, there are two pulleys which are mounted on this frame at points A and B, and we have to find reaction forces at the supports D and E. Here again, when we draw the FBD of the entire frame, we shall have four unknowns, that is four reaction components, two at point D and two at point E. And by writing the equilibrium equations, which are three numbers, we shall not be able to solve all the four unknowns. But nevertheless, let's go ahead and solve as many unknowns as possible. And we know that the remaining unknowns can be found by dismembering the entire frame and drawing FBD of one of the members and solving for the remaining unknowns. So let us go ahead and draw the FBD of the entire frame. The FBD of the entire frame looks like this. First, we write the moment equation about point E, thus eliminating these two forces and the force dy, which all pass through point E, and our equation, the moment equation, will have just one unknown, dx. So dx time 1.5, this distance, and this creates a clockwise moment, therefore the minus sign, the external force of 4.8 kN produces anti-clockwise moment, and the moment arm is the radius of this pulley plus the distance of 4 meters from this point to point E, and that will be 4.25 meters. So this equation would give dx as 13.6 kilonewtons. And next we write the force balance equation in horizontal or x direction, and we'll have just two forces involved, dx plus ex equal to 0, and therefore ex would turn out to minus 13.6 kilonewtons. So we've been able to get this value of this unknown and this unknown. These two are remaining, and we write the force balance equation in the y direction, and that will give us dy plus ey minus 4.8 kilonewtons equal to 0. And we shall not be able to proceed further, and therefore we'll have to dismember the entire frame and write equilibrium equation for any of the members. So here is the FBD of member ABD. We could have taken this member also, but just for the purpose of this solution, we have opted to take this member. And notice here that we have removed the pulleys from the member AD. And when we remove the pulleys, the tension force in the cable here acting on the pulley gets shifted parallelly to the center. Even this tension force here will get shifted to the center point. So it will look like this. Each of them would be of magnitude 4.8 kilonewtons. This is parallel to the vertical force, tension force in cable from B to C, and this is parallel to the direction B to A. And why it is 4.8 kilonewtons? Because this is a single cable and the tension in the cable would be same throughout its length. Similarly, when we remove this pulley, these two forces, each of 4.8 kilonewtons, would get shifted in a parallel direction to the center. So we show this two forces in red color. These are 4.8 kilonewtons each of them, and these two, AX and AY, are the reaction forces due to the member ACE. You may ask, how come the forces acting on the pulleys here, as shown here in this diagram, have been shifted to the center points of the pulleys? That can be explained from the following diagram. So take a look at this example. When these two forces T act at a pulley along the rim in these two directions, this is equivalent to the forces getting shifted to the center point like this, and these two are equivalent. Notice here that we have removed the pulley, therefore the forces have been shifted to point A, and such transformation is very easy to handle. I have explained the reason for this kind of a shifting of the forces in another video, the link of which you will find in the description box below, or it will appear in the top right corner as a video card. I have given a detailed explanation there, and you can watch that video and understand why these two are equivalent. We have done the same thing here. Also notice that the pulleys are mounted on the pins, and they exert force on the pin, and the pin at B and A are assumed to be belonging to the member ABD, and the forces therefore get transferred to the members. Recall that in the case of trusses, we treat pins separately and we draw a BD of the pins and we show the forces acting on the pins. But in frames, it is a normal practice to consider pin as part of one of the member and show the forces acting on the members. So here we have assumed that the pins on which the pulleys are mounted are part of the member ABD, and therefore the forces acting due to cable tension on the pulleys get shifted to the pin and therefore the member at these two points, right? So now in this FBD, we take moment of all the forces about point A. So all the forces get eliminated from our moment equation. Even this force, 4.8 kilonewtons force acting at B, passes through point A and therefore will not contribute to the moment. Now this force produces clockwise moment, and its moment arm is 2 meters, this distance, and therefore minus 4.8 times 2 plus dy times 4, dy produces anti-clockwise moment, and therefore it's positive, and the force dx of 13.6 kilonewtons again produces clockwise moment, and therefore it will be minus 13.6, and its moment arm would be this distance, which is 1.5 meters. So we can write this equation, and by solving it, we will get the value of dy as 7.5 kilonewtons. And once we plug in this value in our equation number 1, we will get the value of Ey. So Ey turns out to be minus 2.7 kilonewtons. So these are the values of dx, dy, and Ex and Ey. We have shown the magnitude and the direction of these forces, and we are done. Just want to add that in this particular solution, we have removed the pulleys from the member. You could have drawn a BD of the members, including the pulleys, as we did in the previous problem, and still you would get the same answer. So in case you have any questions on these two problems, please do write them in the comment section below, and I would answer as soon as possible. In case you have liked the video, please give your thumbs up, share it with your friends, and in case you are new to the channel, please do subscribe. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.